A rivet is measured by the installation thickness of the material you're going to be installing it in. So if you're installing two pieces of metal together, to select the correct rivet, you need to measure the thickness of those two materials together. When you receive your rivets, don't take a tape measure and measure from this point to this point. That's not going to be correct. You're going to find it's going to be about 1/8 to 3/16 inch longer than what you've purchased. So the correct way would be to get one of these babies, okay? This is called a rivet measuring tool. So it has all the sizes on the side here, which are gauge, okay? So they go from size 3 all the way up to size 8. So I'm gonna try to stick it in the hole. It won't go into a 3, but it goes right into a 4. So we know its diameter is a number 4, and then we're gonna be looking for length. It won't fit into this. This is where you find out the length. So it's the second one, and it comes in right at 44. So this is a 44, 4 being the diameter, and the next 4 being the length. It can come in 42, 44, 46, 48, all dependent upon the amount of material you're going to be gripping. What this board will show you is the difference between US threads per inch and metric thread pitch. Two different things. Okay, so when you're using addressing a US bolt, it's threads per inch. So you measure an inch, you count the threads in that inch, and that's the threads per inch. It's the amount of threads that are measured in 1 inch. And as you can see here, we wrote here, the bolt is 1/4 20 by 2 inch. The 1/4 is the diameter. The 20 is the threads per inch. And the 2 inches long is measured from under the head to the end of the bolt. That gives you your total bolt information. Metric, it's thread pitch, not threads per inch. So it's the pitch between the two high points of the thread. And how you would read that, it would be the distance between the peaks, the two peaks you see there. And then you see here M2 by 0.4 by 5 millimeter, okay? So the 2 is the diameter, which is from this point to this point. The 0.4 is the thread pitch from the high point to the high point. And then the 5M is the length from under the head to the end of the bolt. So to measure this hex cap screw, I would go to look what hole it would slide in snugly, and we can see it fits in the 1/4 20. This is the 5/16. It's too big. It's just slopping around in there. So we know that it's 1/4. And then to measure the length, because hex cap screws are measured from under the head, so we would measure it from this side. This has two measuring points. I'm sorry, it would be this side. We have two measuring points. This little angle cut in here is made for a flathead, and this side is made for the length, okay, from under the head. So in this situation, we would see that this is 7/8 of an inch when all said and done. This is 1 inch, and it's 1/8 less, so we have 7/8 of an inch. So we know it's 1/4 inch by 7/8. When you're measuring a flathead socket cap, a flathead sheet metal screw, or flathead wood screw, or a deck screw, this notch right here, that is made so you can get the length, okay? And the length of this, which includes the head, would be 2.5 inches long. This is another gauge where you can measure or find out what type of thread you have. And this is a metric. I have one that's in here that you can go to each one of these until it fits. And then you can find out at that point what thread you have along with the size. Because on here, it'll tell you that this is an M6 by 1.0. So you have an M6 by 1.0 thread pitch. So that's all for metric. We have another thread gauge. This is for Imperial sizes. Here's a knot. This is half 13, okay? Put the nut on, you can find what size that this will fit on. This is half 20, it doesn't work, it doesn't go on. So the half 13, we know that this is a half 13, along with a hex cap screw that I have in here that I'm unscrewing, you screw it back in. And that size, I believe, is 1/4 20. So if I wanted to measure this flat washer, the inside, which I know that this is 1 inch, I believe, so it should be more than 1 inch, so a 1 inch bolt can fit in that. These two prongs on the outside measure inside diameter, and this measures out as 1.062. And now it just went to 1 point because I pulled it out. So it's possible if it's not totally straight in there because it's round, I'm trying to get a number, and that's a good way to make sure you got the right number. So 1.059. That's what it's coming up with, 1.059. And that's fine because if you're putting a 1 inch bolt into this, you need that extra room for the bolt to fit in there properly. You can also measure with the caliper an outside diameter, okay? Which will say that the outside of this washer is 2.014 inches. So it's just over 1 inch. And you can measure the thickness. So that's 0.1175. So this is a very handy tool to have. You can do many different things with it. You want to measure inside this area. You can take this end piece here, which is a ruler basically, and you can push it in there, and then you can push it down, and you know the depth. That's 0.447 from the top to the bottom of the inside.